Welcome back to Cinema News, Ria Ataide.
Hello, thanks for having me.
Belated happy birthday.
You also at the...
Thank you. So, 31st birthday. Mm-hmm. And we saw the photos that you and your super close friends shared online. How does it feel to be like officially in the third decade of your life? Kasi 30 is parang medyo... Gumanon pa sa late 20s.
Yeah, but
31 is like officially in your third decade. How has it been so far?
It's been good. I feel like because my 30th also ushered in a lot of new changes. I moved out officially. I live alone now. So parang mas naramdaman ko yung pagiging adult. At tama nga sila. The 30s is like your 20s pero with budgeting your own money. Ganun.
But also harder or more fun?
I think it's a mix of both. I do miss my family. I miss my parents and them being easily accessible. But I do enjoy yung freedom that comes with this. Na, I don't know, siguro making my own decisions and being more accountable. But I guess the hardest part is really the time away from my family. As a rule, my parents... Well, actually, yun lang din naman hiniling ni mommy when me and Arjo decided to like live independently na we still make time for the family, special occasions, and Sundays.
Unless so Sundays is the...
Unless there's work or you're sick. Yeah.
Yun lang ang excuse, yeah. You were talking about your 30s or turning 30 and big changes. And one of the most, I guess, shocking things that you did was a super duper beautiful photo shoot that was very, very empowering. I've never gotten to ask you about this, but how was that? What was the preparation like? And even going further back, what was your reaction when they asked you?
Okay, let's do the reaction muna. So, nung they pitched it to us, Tito Chuk Gomez, who handles our PR, pitched it to both my parents. No, they were also there. So, when they were in agreement na okay, we're open to this for her. This is something that they think, because it speaks about something I really stand for, which is really body positivity, you know, especially now, because I recently found out that I have hypothyroidism. So all the more now I'm advocating for body positivity because yun nga, no matter what I do, I don't lose weight as much as I'd want to because apparently it's scientific. So all the more I want to advocate for it. So I'm really grateful that White Castle took the chance on me. And I feel as though it's a very powerful and necessary message. Given na, diba, on social media, yung standards ng society, the beauty standards and all of that, medyo nakaka-affect din talaga sa mental health nating lahat. And in terms of not naman inducing, but being one of the reasons why a lot of the people now have body dysmorphia, no? So I was really glad na they asked me. And then when they asked me, the preparation then was more like self-care na lang. Ay, hindi na ako umasang I was gonna lose weight for it. You know, I really just prepared, ate healthy or ate properly, indulged less at most. And parang it wouldn't be so truthful if I tried to lose weight for it.
Yun right, nga, right.
Advocating for body positivity, tapos mag-crash diet ka. No naman, I did it. So yun. Oh, and part of the preparation was talking to the men in my family. Hey, heads up.
So who was the most like...
My brother.
Arjo.
Yeah. Actually, even my little brother, both of them, medyo conservative kasi sila in that sense. And pero they were really happy with how it turned out because they did it very tastefully. They were just kind of scared na, you know, stereotypical calendar girl image na pakak, show everything. And we opted for the other direction naman, so.
Yeah, and it was so beautifully done. I mean, that's the type na talagang pagtanda mo, you're like, look at that, that's me. Beautiful, no, beautifully done.
I think being growing up a big girl, that's not something I would have expected for myself talaga. Like, it was not something I could ever have imagined. That's why I'm so grateful for it. And parang, you know, the great part that came out of that was people now would reach out to me and be like, thank you. Because of how you see yourself, I believe that I can see myself the same way too. You know, it's the little things like that I am most grateful for. Na kahit papano, I was able to create some change in the way people see themselves too.
Yeah, pushing it forward, especially, of course, a woman we all admire as well, Iza Calzado, very similar, yes. Like body outlook. And I feel like yun nga ang ganda because younger girls who look to Iza are like, hey, I see myself in you and I am beautiful too, diba? It's so
actually,
empowering.
To add to that, si Ate Isa is actually one of the reasons why I learned to love myself a lot more also.
Oh.
So it's so, yeah, super. She, if not for her, I wouldn't be as confident as I am talaga.
You did talk about something. Miles Ocampo recently also came out with a story about her thyroid. This was on Magandang Buhay.
I know, with her, they removed her thyroid eh.
Yeah, she had an operation.
It's treatable pa without surgery. So I'm medicating for it with the same doctors that helped Moira with her hormones.
Same as Moira. Okay, when did you find out? And actually, why did you even go to...
Kasi no matter how much I would work out or even cut down on food, nothing was happening. As in like, yung frustrating na talaga. Because naman, you know, you work out din naman, you don't expect to lose weight. But given how much I was working out, I was like, kahit naman papano dapat. I'm also very, very lamigan. And they, apparently that also has something to do with it because that's your metabolism being too slow. And then I have this Aura ring, which kind of works like a Fitbit or like an Apple Watch that monitors your health. And then I saw that my heart rate variability wasn't good. It was like always on the red zone. So when I consulted, that's when they were like, oh, your metabolism isn't working as well as it should. And then we did the tests. And then there, they figured out, nah, okay, that's why.
Okay, so for those of us who are not familiar, because there's hypo and hyper. What is hyper?
Hyper is opposite of mine. Hypothyroidism naman is when there isn't enough thyroid hormones in your bloodstream and your metabolism slows down. Like, that's what happens. Hyper is the one where you like your metabolism naman is too fast, I think.
Wait, is this similar to Shaina Magdayo?
Yes. Hypo. Yes, I've heard she had this as well.
So what has changed since you found out?
The way I see myself also. I'm a lot less hard on myself. Kasi diba, even if, yun nga eh, as much as I do advocate for body positivity, there are still those that think na it isn't what it should be. And to be real, in TV and movies, it's plus 10, 15 pounds. So that's a lot harder for me, especially if I want to take on roles that have to be a lot more flattering or whatever. So it's harder for me. So I think now it's a lot more, I just keep reminding myself, don't be hard on yourself. You'll lose weight naturally. It's all scientific. That's the thing. That's the only thing I keep saying. Kung di ko naman makakalaban ng science, hello. And I don't want to do crash diets naman. So now I'm a lot more patient with myself.
And I guess ang pinaka-importante dun is you're actually aware that it's there and so you can do something about it.
Yun talaga. Kasi for the longest time, you know, so frustrating and not knowing and now finally making sense. Yung parang, it was one of those moments na nakakaiyak for me na parang, shit, finally, I make sense to me.
Yeah. And before we leave the body positivity topic, this was super cute because your mom's chopper moment went viral. Kung saan pinabalik niya yung chopper para lang ma-video yung iyo billboard. Yeah. Your parents have always been so supportive of your different endeavors. So how do moments like that and everything in between feel?
It's overwhelming to have that kind of support. Parang if anything, it makes me want to strive more to make them proud. You know, like it's positive reinforcement for me talaga. I'm so grateful that that's how my family works kasi in this day and age, ang daming pumapasok na negativity or people try to give you negativity and it's a matter of having a solid support system for you to really survive without being so affected by the noise. And I'm so grateful I have that. As extravagant as my mother may be, like it's I'm so grateful.
Being the mom that she is, ganun talaga. I did want to go to another topic because very, very soon you shall be giving away a brother to the altar.
Yes.
How are you feeling about that? I know how close you and RJ are.
Your brother, ate. You're also close to yours, no? Kakaiyak.
I exactly why I asked this. Because the whole wedding, I was crying. Oh, eh. Mas daig ko pa nanay ko. The
yun
whole
nga,
wedding,
feel ko ganun din ako. Kasi proposal pa lang, I was already such a mess. It's not, and it's not like a sad thing. Siguro it's bittersweet because part of growing up is really seeing different versions of each other, right? And it's overwhelming. It's like, I'm happy for him, but I'm also sad that he won't be as accessible as before. But I think this is good training. Like, living away from each other has been good training for us. I'm just grateful it's Maine. Kasi she really brings out the best in him. And I'm so happy. Like, they're a perfect match. I don't know if you see their videos online, like that roller coaster video. Like, kaya nilang sabayan yung trip ng isa't isa. And it's so nice to know. It puts me at ease knowing that that's who I'm giving my brother to.
Oh,
na parang, yeah, and a new addition to the family, another sister. I'm so excited.
Oh.
Yeah. Just thinking about giving a speech, naiiyak na ako.
Speaking of exciting, and with your brother, parang ang dami nangyari sa inyo the past 3 years between the two of you pa lang. You did travel to Cannes for Cattleya Killer last year. Was that last year?
Last year, October.
But two little birds told me that you will be going to Cannes again soon, but for a different project. Are you allowed to talk about that at all?
We'll be there in May, this time for the film festival screening naman. And it's another project that we co-produced under Nathan Studios. And Arch is also part of it. I mean, I feel like that's at most what I can say, but yeah.
Wow, so you're a co-producer on this project that you're flying to Cannes again for.
Yes, I'm not an actress though for this time.
Amazing. What is that experience like being on the other side?
You know, Ate, I feel like it's given me a lot more understanding and compassion with the production also. What goes into production, why there are certain changes that happen sometimes na can be frustrating for actors, but it makes perfect sense for producers. My course is coming in handy because this is actually what I took up in college, Comm Arts in La Salle. So I'm finally able to apply what I learned. Nice.
Then. What made you decide to try it out, producing?
Actually, it's our parents that really, like right now, it's more them in the forefront of this. It really started also nung my shutdown for ABS because we saw that there was an opportunity to help others that really needed help during that time. And now it's nice to be able to provide jobs for people that need it most and people we know are competent and people we know that actually will do the job. Yeah, and it's just all of those factors. We want to create things. We want to help people that were displaced and also to be able to create content that we want to work on.
So this thing in May is a festival?
It's the film festival, the Cannes Film Festival.
It's the actual Cannes Film Festival. So you are for exhibition, you are for competition. What is the...
term? We are showcasing, for sure. There is a showcase. Yeah.
That is super, super exciting.
I know.
This has been very interesting to me because, like you said kanina, you have a lot of friends talaga. And time again through the years, you've been linked to many different absolutely eligible bachelors, right? So one of your best friends, Enchong Di, ilang beses na link sa'yo. And then for a time, Joshua Garcia, pinipilit na mga tao na kayo. And of course, you've known Zanjo for a long time. And many other, I guess, guys who are in your circle who, hey, not bad. How do you know and how did you know that you were ready for more than friendship this time around?
I think it just made sense. You just feel it, I think. I don't know. It just felt right.
But how does that happen? Like, because I've read here that the first project together was My Dear Heart. So that was more 6-ish years ago.
2017. It was 2017.
But at that time, friends.
Friends.
And I've never had kasi a crossover of like friendship to how does that
happen?
You know
what? Me kasi,
is it weird or not weird?
No, I think the only thing that scares me about starting out as friends is, you know, if it doesn't work out, you lose not only a partner, you also lose a friend. Mm. Me kasi ate, parang everybody that I went out with really did begin from friendship. Kasi I'm one of the guys, I guess. Like, it's not, I've not been the ligawin type. You know, I told you, I grew up a big girl and all of that. So all the guys that I did go out with in the past all started out from friendship. Na it's more of a personality thing na, and all of that. With this one, it just made sense. Like, we just started seeing each other a lot more and it just led to that.
Oh my gosh, did it start with like kanchao within Catherine, Danielle, Joshua, etc.?
Actually, parang hindi rin. Medyo, I don't know. It just started. Like, when you're asking me nga, I'm like, ha, oo nga, no? Did it? A little bit siguro, but not so, I don't know. Kasi,
aminin natin, the body language of a girl and guy best friend is very similar, right? So parang yeah. I'm imagining myself, if I were like in your barkada, I wonder how I could spot that iba na yung akbay and iba na yung parang leaning, mga ganyan.
Yeah. Maybe. I don't know. I really don't know.
This is so cute. Okay, but the cuter part is for the longest time, there were speculations, right? People would post like paparazzi shots of spotting you and Zanjo together wherever. But the confirmation actually came again from your mom. Was that a surprise? Were you like,
hey, yes.
Oh my God, mom!
Yes, yes, Ate. Like, exactly like that. Like, but she did message me that like, oh, na interview ako about you and Zandra. I didn't know it. You know, she didn't want to lie naman. And then there, I was just like, huh? Why? And this was right before we were leaving for Cannes. It wouldn't have come from us din kasi talaga. Because we wanted to keep it as low-key siguro. For me, if I really want something to work, I want to keep it to myself.
So how were the conversations, I guess, after that when wala na, nasabi na ng mommy mo to the world. How did you and Zanjo take that? Parang, la, yun na yun.
Let them know. It was just like, ah, okay. Like, yeah, I think I was a lot more worried about that than he was, I think. I don't know. I was just worried about how he would take it, actually. More than how it would affect me. Parang, kasi diba, if he's also not comfortable sharing that information pa pala, baka nabigla and all of that. Pero okay naman.
Yeah.
We are now.
Yes. And I feel like there's a good balance even with the couples you're surrounded with in your barkada because they're also all very, although public sila, they're very private about like what happened.
Yeah.
So parang, why do I feel like there's this, you guys protect each other in this group?
I feel like because we know what it's like to be the other person, to be in that position. And we all want to protect what's ours for ourselves. And it's nice. It's nice to have friends that get it na hindi mo na kailangan i-explain.
Yeah, that's true. And it's so nice that you're actually able to work together and travel together and celebrate birthdays together. You said kanina na parang it just felt natural. What is that like?
Comfortable, where you don't have to pretend to be anything else. Because I feel like in relationships, a lot of people are like best foot forward. You know, there's a part of you that you kind of hide. But with me, kasi parang, you know, you've known each other for so long. It's comfortable. It's, I feel like I can be 100% myself.
Yeah.
All my weirdness, all my little... Yeah.
Oh, I love that. I love that for you. And you know, there's this while you talk about it, there's a parang I can see the parang there's a ano here and then there's a glimmer in your eye. That's the best part. We did talk earlier about your mom being the one to break the news, kumbaga, to the public. And technically, medyo wala na kayong nagawa doon because it has been done. Why are you okay with being open about it, I guess, is the question. Compared to the past relationships you've had.
Well, it just makes it easier on our end too. You know, like if we're seen in public, we don't have to explain ourselves. Not that we really do, but you know,
yeah.
just gives people something to talk about, and you know, para wala nang sasabihin. I think it's really that. It's really more like, it is what it is. We're going out. What now?
Yeah, exactly. And parang you're right in that in the first place, hindi naman kailangan i-explain talaga.
Yeah. Yeah. You know, it's just easier siguro with that, maneuvering when in public. But otherwise, I don't think anything has changed really. Yeah, it's not like we're constantly posting on social media too.
Yeah. Hindi nga eh. It's parang little breadcrumbs lang here and there. Believe though, he was the first one who tagged you during the Japan trip. Is that correct?
Yes.
Did you know that it would, kasi that was like, di ba they call it soft launch? Parang may, and it was an artsy shot pa of you eh, parang ganun, I remember. So, did you know that that would be, kasi people would talk, like generally, in because it was a public post, right? Did he tell you about that? Or were you like, oh, tinag ako, I guess.
Yeah, oh, tinag ako. Oh, okay, so we're doing that now. Like, oh. Yeah, I feel like some things you don't have to talk about na rin naman kasi, like, yeah. Yun nga, I know at that point, he's like, people already know anyway.
Just I love how chill the energies are. Yeah. I super get that and I love it. I do have a last question. What is your love language and what have you found is Zanjo's love language?
Me, I'm definitely acts of service and giving gifts. That's what I like giving. In terms of receiving, I do like receiving acts of service and quality time. And luckily, I've noticed he seems to be the same naman.
And that's so, I guess, important knowing that kasi baka parang effort ka ng effort yung pala
the other person sees it. If you don't explain yourself, di ba?
Yeah.
Kailangan mag-explain. I mean, a presentation. Charot.
But this is such an exciting stage in your life, both personal life and career. Please share what your fans can expect or look forward to with Kat Clea Killer and other projects that you can share with us.
Kat Clea Killer will be launched very, very, very soon. I'm so excited for everyone to see that. We're also about to get started on the teleserye with me, Jane Oineza, Tony Dobruska, and JC De Vera under JRB Production. So that's all in the pipeline within this year. X Factor, the series I worked on last year with Cardo Aquino and J.K. Harrisito, will also be launched this year. And yeah, I think that's pretty much it for this year.
We'd like to play a little game, and this is a play on letters. So we like to call it From A to Z. So we're going to share a few topics, etc. And you're going to share like the extremes of it, the A to Z of it. Okay, first, what do you like doing when spending time alone? And what do you like doing most when spending time with your friends?
Alone, maybe binge watching series and movies.
What type of series are you into?
I like all. I really don't pick. Lately, I've been into crime thriller because of Kat Clea Killer. After working on that, I've been like into that. I just started on Marvelous Mrs. Maisel on Prime Video. It's enjoyable. I like comedies. I like sometimes different things. During the day, I like yung mga you can focus on. At night, gusto ko yung hindi na ako mag-iisip.
Yeah.
So I rewatch Friends like all the time too. Para at night, that's my night. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Then with friends, more sitting down, catching up and talking in person. Or doing the same thing, watching together and eating, of course. Like,
oh, that's really the best. Yung mga parang it doesn't have to be a grand gimmick.
Yeah, coexisting is nice, ate.
Yes.
And that word. You can be quiet and just like,
oh my gosh. Okay, this is a bit tricky. About Zanjo, your absolute favorite thing and least favorite thing about him.
He makes me laugh. And I think it goes both ways because even when you're pikon, di ba? Nakakapikon yung pikon ko na tatawa ka pa. But there, so there. Like without
does saying, it work on you?
Yeah.
So that's why worst kasi, gumana na naman. Yeah, a lot are like
but
that.
But it's nice to always laugh. I think humor is a big deal in a relationship. Now I realized it's important na same kayo din.
Okay, last. the extremes of having a very, very private relationship and now having a more publicly known relationship. What is that like?
Well, first of all, it still amuses me na, you know, people are all up in the business of who we should be dating and if we should be dating. Like, anong ba't ka may input? Like, yun lang naman. Bakit? Ikaw ba? Ikaw ba involved? Yun lang naman. I think it's really the energy that's sent to you, the energy that you feel. Mm. Parang, it's hard to, ang dami kasing kumukuda, you know, sometimes. I mean, not naman that people are talking about us in a bad way, ha? I'm just saying, like, it's just,
in general.
So many opinions in general, and I don't want to be affected by them kasi I don't want to have something I hold so dear talked about in ways that they, I don't know, they shouldn't feel entitled to talk about it kasi. Yeah. But it's life, it comes to the territory.
And that is it for our show this weekend. Thank you so much for watching and thank you for making us a part of your weekend habit. We'll see you all again next week. This has been Cinema News.